I'm working on my household budget, and I've answered all of my bills for the last 2 months. Now that I have my information entered, I can clean up my worksheet a little. For example, some of the text in column A goes beyond the column marker. I can easily make the column wider. Just position the cursor over the column line right in the column heading, and a double arrow will appear. Left-click the mouse and drag the cursor to the right to increase the column size. Release the mouse button when the column is the desired size. It's bigger now, but I think it's a little too big. I can decrease the column size the same way, but this time I'll just drag the cursor to the left. There, that looks a lot better. Some of the names of the months don't quite fit in the cell either, and I can increase the column width on these too. Now, I can manually adjust the column marker like I just did for column A, or I can use the format command to adjust the column width. Just select the column you'd like to modify and then click the format command in the cells group on the Home tab. A menu appears with a lot of options. From this menu, you can change your row height and your column width. If you click column width, a dialog box appears that allows you to enter a specific size for the width. I'm not sure how wide I need it to be, so this won't work. However, the auto-fit column width adjusts the column just enough so all the text will fit. Just left-click the menu option to select it. And now you can see that the column adjusted in the worksheet. Right now, the height of the rows in the spreadsheet looks okay, but there may be times when you want to increase or decrease the height of your rows. This works the same way as the columns. For example, let's say I want to increase the height of row 1. After all, it is my title. I do want it to stand out. All you have to do is hover your cursor over the row line you want to move. Once the double arrow appears, left click and drag your mouse. I want to make this row taller, so I'll drag the row line down. You can drag the line up and down until you get the size you like. And just like the columns, you can format the rows by clicking the format command in the cells group on the Home tab. From the menu, you can select row height to enter a specific cell height or auto-fit row height to adjust the row height to the same size as the text. You may also find that you need to sometimes insert rows, columns, and cells. For example, I just realized that I forgot to include my car insurance in my budget. Instead of adding it to the bottom of the list, I'd like to put it above my car payment. All I need to do is select row 9, then click the Inserts command. The new row always appears above the selected row. And now I can type in my text. One word of caution. Make sure that you select the entire row below where you want the new row to appear and not just the cell. For example, if I want to insert a new row above rent and I only select cell A8 instead of row 8, it won't work quite right. You see, now if I click the insert command, only a cell will be inserted instead of a row. So I'll just click undo, select the entire row, and then click insert. You can also insert columns easily. I want to change the dates column to August due date, and then insert a column next to it where I can type yes or no if it was paid. Each month, I'll change this information. When you insert a new column into a worksheet, it will appear to the left of the column you select. Since I want my new column to appear here, to the right of the due date column, I need to select column C and then click the insert command. There you go. Deleting rows and columns is as easy as adding them. Just select the row or column you'd like to delete and click the Delete command on the Home tab. I do want to keep this row, so I'll click Undo. Just be careful to select the entire row or column you want to delete. If you only select a cell and then click Delete, only the cell will disappear. Excel gives you several different ways to insert cells and rows, and you'll learn more about these as you use Excel. I think I've shown you the simplest way to add and delete rows and columns, but feel free to explore some of the other options as well. If you click the down arrow next to the Insert and Delete commands, you'll see some other menu options. I'm going to really quickly add a few more rows that will help me organize the budget into categories. The best way to learn how to insert and delete rows, columns, and cells is to practice using them. Have fun!